Soundings presents an unabridged recording of A Troubled Course, written by David Donachie and read by John Telfer. The moral right of the author has been asserted. This performance is owned by Soundings. Chapter 1. John Pierce was sure everything would have gone as planned if the weather had not changed so drastically. Such an occurrence could hardly be a surprise, given the position they occupied on the Atlantic shore of the Iberian Peninsula. It was an area subject to huge rollers at the best of times, as well as being at the mercy of sudden changes in the conditions. Severe storms could come in from the Caribbean or the Southern Ocean, creating the kind of monstrous and crashing waves which had over millennia shaped the rocky shoreline and, no doubt, the character of the people. It was only later he reflected on this, reasoning that folk who lived by and depended on such an unpredictable sea, and too often died from the way it behaved, had a natural resilience not gifted to everyone. Yet, even if the increase in the strength of the wind was noticeable, creating the need to watch out for the unexpected movement of plates and goblets at the dining table, there was no expectation of danger. Neither he nor his fellow commanding officer, Captain Lord Langham, felt the need to react to the changing circumstances. The need they might be obliged to do so was flagged up by both the sailing masters of Lord Langham's vessel HMS Lively and Mr. Williams of HMS Hazard, who were alarmed not just by the increasing wind, but also by the cloud formations visible on the horizon. The news was imparted in a whispered exchange by his man to Langham, he being the senior, and this happened as the officers of both vessels were near to completing, in all respects bar one, what had been a capital dinner.